We've just concluded our two-day biannual delegate conference here in Castlebar. We had over 180 delegates who took part in this conference, where the theme of our conference was Proud of Our Past, Rebuilding for the Future. And at the conference, we had motions on Brexit, childcare, agency workers, and particularly precarious employment. All our delegates took part in the motions and the debate. We also heard from activists in some of the work they've done in the last 2 years to secure pay increases for our members, to secure permanent contracts of employment for our members, and to improve the terms and conditions.
I'm here representing the manufacturing division, electronics and engineering. I'm also here as a delegate from SIP to Limerick District Council. It's been fabulous to turn up here, meet some of the old and new colleagues at the conference. Some of the motions that are being put to the floor, very important, especially going forward, the likes of the housing crisis, the health issues that we're facing. And then you also, yesterday, had Patricia King highlighting the issues around Brexit and that sort of situation that's going to face us in the future. So I think it's vital that SIPTO members are aware of these issues and act on them.
The conference here in Castlebar the last couple of days was a huge success. It's great for everybody to meet up and tie in with each other and get lots of information of what's going on in the various different workplaces in the manufacturing division. I myself spoke on the Big Start campaign, something that I don't work in that sector, but it affects me. It affects all of us as workers, because we need quality childcare for our children. And a big part of that is we want reduced costs, but we don't want it to be at the expense of our comrades in that sector.
So I'm just recently became as a shop steward of the Kerry Foods. I have 300 people, and this was my first experience for the conference. So I really enjoyed it, and it was good time, and it was loads of new information for me, so I can pass to another SIPTO members, and it was nice evening to meet new friends, to chat about things like how everything going in other factories. But basically, when you start to work in Ireland as an hourly paid worker, it's not so easy, and you don't feel protected once you don't have SIPTO membership.
It's my first time attending the conference. I have to say I've enjoyed the experience so far. The speakers have all spoke very well. It's been very informative. The message I'll take back to my fellow workers is that SIPTO is continuing to grow. We're winning pay deals for all our members. SIPTO is definitely on the offensive.